Carlo and Brendan here from Games, Brains and a Headbanging Life. GBHBL.com for short. It's track by track times. We're going to one of the oldies. One of the classic rock bands slash albums as well. Although I got really confused thinking this was the big hitter. But it's not. It's Hysteria, isn't it?
Hysteria.
Yeah, that's the one that's the big hitter. But I think this is certainly probably the second, because there are a lot of tracks I recognised on it, and I'm not a Def Leppard fan by any stretch.
I don't know where it ranks. This is my favourite Def Leppard album. And this is, I believe, in the best of my memory, the second ever album I owned.
Really?
And there is one song on this song in particular that I remember, as well as another song which was on the first album I owned, not a Def Leppard one, that I've always kind of said, like, it was one song by Lita Ford and one song on this album that I felt were when it started for me, the journey into metal.
That's so weird.
And that's why this album has been, like, I wouldn't say, like, it's not like it's a big deal so much to me now, although I still very, very much love the song, which we'll get to, obviously, when we get through the tracks.
Okay.
But, yeah, it was, like, a real night for me. This was a massive nostalgia hit, man. It was, like, I was listening back to it. I was remembering bits I loved. I was remembering songs that I haven't listened to for years. And I was remembering songs I remember not liking so much back then and listening to now and thinking, I still don't like it. That's kind of cool.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. So it matched up.
Yeah. Yeah, so I remember owning this on cassette. There you go.
I never owned it. I never cared for Def Leppard. I knew the hits. I knew some. And I recognised one or two off this album. But yeah, I still don't care for Def Leppard. I've even seen them live at Download many, many years ago. And it's sugar rock for me. And that's pretty much how it starts as well, with Rock Rock Till You Drop. So 80s sugar rock, it makes my teeth ache. Nice groove though, and one hell of a catchy sing-along chorus. The solo is my favourite part here. Really gets my blood pumping.
Yep, you know, obviously, despite 80s songs having to have as terrible a title as you can possibly mm-hmm. come up with, seems to be a thing. It is a very, very catchy rock song. Bit of a kind of AC/DC feel, but that was just what all this sounded like back in the day.
Yeah.
Catchy chorus, fun solo, you know. As much as I'd love to sit around and try and be all hardcore and whatnot and say I don't like it, the truth is, it's fun. It's a fun song. I didn't mind it.
Yeah, it's that. So there's nothing wrong with it. If it's on, it's a radio rock song, yeah. And that's fine. That's fine. A Photograph. I like the vocals more in this one. I find the riffs and rhythm a little bit sexy, and once again, it's a catchy listen. It leans towards a poppier sound, especially with the chorus. But I do quite like it. And again, the guitar solo is quite fire here.
Yeah, it's another song I've always liked. And yep. I think it's generally seen as one of the band's big hitters anyway.
This is one I recognised.
Yeah, it's got Infectious, it's nice rhythm, nice vocals. Another good chorus, good riffs, good solos. It's a decent track. You can see why it captured people's imagination, you know, went on to be one of their big hitters.
Yeah. And as a starting point to an album, two catchy rock numbers.
Yeah.
It ain't no different with Stage Fright. Really like this track too. The live style that they kind of got going here actually really hits me right, and it's very old school. That kind of warms my heart. Another killer solo, another catchy chorus, just a banging track.
I'm not massive on this one. This isn't one of my favourites on the album. I like parts of it. You know, I think the verse have a bit more meat and a bit of a harder sounding kind of guitar tone. I just think overall, I find the chorus particularly annoying. Solo's good. I think there's good things in it. You know, but it's just not one I remember ever liking very much, and I didn't kind of like it again.
So it's really interesting, because now I'm wondering which is the one that, you know. It hasn't come up yet, and I have less good things to say as we go on. Too Late for Love. A bit of moodiness to this one at the start, and Harmonia's vocal sounds good. A bit of a rock ballad once it properly kicks in. I find it all right. Doesn't get me bopping as the others did so far, and I find it really repetitive by the end.
I've kind of pointed out it's got a weird computer effect in the intro, which just seems very out of place for anything that Def Leppard have done on this album so far. I don't mind the song though. I've kind of pointed out it's got that stadium kind of rock, big anthem sort of feel to it as well. Catchy enough, well sung, flows nicely, decent solo. Yeah, it's okay. It's nothing special.
It's okay.
It's alright.
Die Hard the Hunter. I like the groove of this one once it gets going, but the intro really lost me. Once I got a bad taste out of my mouth, I thought this was a nice slab of danceable rock. and roll. The solo is probably the best part, and it really, I like the fact the solo goes on for quite a while, which I quite enjoyed.
Yeah. This isn't the song, but this I do remember loving this song when I was younger.
Mm.
It's been one of the songs I really, really liked from the album. So I was quite excited. I haven't listened to this song since I was younger.
Okay.
So I was kind of like equally excited, equally worried to listen to it in case, you know, that nostalgia memory isn't at what it is now. But I did still enjoy it. I was taken back almost instantly. I still enjoyed it a lot. I think it sounds excellent for its age. I love the riff. I think it's got a bit more attitude and it's a bit more on the hard rock side of what Def Leppard normally do. Just in terms of the guitar tone and stuff, not in terms of like, hey, we're going to headbang.
Oh, you know? Yeah.
You know, it's got another solid solo. The only negative I'd have with it, if anything, was that they do stretch out the ending massively.
Oh, yes.
Repeating Die Hard the Hunter about 50 times, fading slowly. It's like, all right, enough.
I get it. Alright, Foolin'. There are parts of this track I like. The moody melodies, the harmonised vocals, and the tempo shifts. But, the Foolin' part, that Foolin' part just does my head in.
Yeah. I started off by saying, oh, they've lost a G, that's sad. I just find that really weird. Like, why wouldn't you just write Foolin'?
Foolin'.
You're an English band, you know, like, just write the word properly.
Isn't it like, if you leave the G on, you're fooling someone. If you leave the G off with apostrophe over the N, it's like, you're fooling around.
I'm not defending it. I think you should stop defending it. I found the slow building verse really, really boring. It completely changes for me, because then I really, because like, the thing with some of the Def Leppard songs, if you listen to them, is like, they have a lot of transitions in their song. And it's often not verse, chorus, verse, chorus. It's often verse, pre-chorus, 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 chorus. Mm. They kind of go into the higher bit with like more of a gang vocal sound and then back and forth. So I can often listen to a Def Leppard song I hate and still find maybe one of the pre-choruses, oh, I really like that.
Okay.
You know, and I did in this, there's one which is anybody kind of out there part of it, which I think is really, really good and sounds awesome. But then I also hate the chorus as well with the fooling. So I love, you know, I love the pre-choruses. I mean, even the solo is a bit odd in this one. The solo isn't particularly good either. So there's one pre-chorus that happens once every verse that I thought was awesome, and I didn't like anything else.
This is some dissection of this track, though, yeah. Man. Get to even any positives. Rock of Ages, and what? How eye-opening was this for me? Because I thought my music player had fucked up and had just gone on shuffle and started to and basically gone from Foolin' to The Offspring's Pretty Fly for a White Guy, because that's apparently where that noise at the start there, you know, the bleep and blopping bit, is from here? I didn't know that. I never knew that. So that was really, really shocking.
Def Leppard just out there inspiring punk bands.
Apparently so, man. That's crazy. But I hated it. I hated it, because as soon as I heard it, I felt every part of me cringe again, like as if I was hearing it for the first time. So getting past that initially was like, okay. Then at Horror Side, this is a fun rocker with a simple beat and some nice riffs. Overall, I find it quite cookie cutter.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same. I liked it more than you did, but I hate the intro as well.
Mm.
Just don't understand it. I don't understand. I never understood it in the Offspring song. No, I don't understand it here. Just play the fucking song.
What is that? You know?
But after that, it's just a fun rock song. It's got a catchy song. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the sort of like Queen's We Will Rock You.
Okay.
It's just, it's not deep. There's no meaning. There's no nothing. It's just a bit of fun.
See, I wondered, because of the title of the track as well, and there being a stage show called Rock of Ages, I was like, is that linked? Is there some reference? Oh. I looked into it and I couldn't find one. Like, I thought it'd be mentioned. I think it's just a coincidence more than anything else. Coming Under Fire, and that's Coming Without a G. I found this track very boring. I zoned out as it sounds way too familiar to everything else. There's nothing objectively wrong with it, but simply put, there's nothing special about this at all. Forgettable.
Yeah, same for me. Another one of those songs. I don't remember this one. I didn't really remember this at all when it played, like I'd listened to it at all, ever. I was obviously sad again about the second G that we've lost in this episode, which was terrible. And it's got all those usual sort of Def Leppard moments, so there's nothing particularly bad in it. You know, the guitars are okay, the singing's okay, everything's okay, but it's just that. Just lacks any magic.
Love that. Lacks magic, man. Penultimate track, Action, Not Word. I like this one a bit more. There's a bit more energy, brief bit of wildness, or at least as wild as this album can possibly get. The guitar solo is an ass kicker here.
Yeah, solo is very, very strong, but that's the only thing I like about this song. I hate the weird tone they have on the string bending right at the very, very beginning. It just instantly from the off makes me feel like, all right, I'm already off. I don't like this. other than everything else, I just thought was pretty standard. There was nothing else about it other than the solo, which was really good.
Which brings us to the end, and I think actually it turns out we are right here. Billy's Got a Gun. For me, this is a very strong finish. Slightly meaner sounding in the verses, and there's some really noticeable bass groove. The chorus is very strong. I really like how high the vocals go here, but the synth is an inspired touch to make this song just that extra bit special. It is a very strong finish.
This is the one.
Very good.
My favourite ever Def Leppard song. First song I probably loved way back in the day from this band.
Mm-hmm.
I love the bass, I love the synth. I think it's darker. It's a bit darker than the rest of the album. It drops a bit of the cheese. It has a bit of a story, you know, which I liked a lot, especially when I was a kid. You know, I would have been 9 or 10 years old listening to this. And as a kid, although now we could, you know, we listen to such deep, dark, aggressive heavy metal, the stories are obviously a lot deeper. But you listen to this as a kid, and I was like, now what's this? What's Billy doing? Like he says at one point in the song, hey Billy, why you got that gun?
Yeah.
And that's what I'd be like as a 10-year-old, like, Billy, put the gun down. But you know, I loved it. I thought it was a bit darker. Like I said, I like the story. I think the chorus is really, really good. It's that building sort of stuff as well. It's got all the hallmarks of Def Leppard, so everything they do is in it.
Yeah.
It's got the solo, it's got the different pre-choruses and the different changes in vocal tones. But it just seems to be put together a little bit better and be a bit more, it almost feels like it's a bit like a serious song, you know, like they was having fun across the album and then they were like, we want to do something a bit different, let's do something a bit serious. So we're not talking like dark and meaty, but it's darker than anything else on the album. And yeah, and I think it's brilliant. But I do always tell everybody, like, when you listen to this, you have to basically ignore the last 50 seconds, because right at the very end of the song it goes into this weird kind of intro, which is seen as part of the song, but it's just an outro to the album.
Yeah.
But because it comes up as part of the song, you could easily go, oh, well, they fucking ruined it though with the last
minute.
And it's like, no, that is not part of it.
Yeah, just snip that part off in your head.
But yeah, best song they ever wrote, in my opinion.
I mean, I couldn't say for sure. I haven't listened to enough of their catalogue for that, but it's a song I really, really did enjoy as well. It's a good ending. Overall, I think the album is perfectly fine. Like, I think there's nothing shit on it. No. There's nothing I hate. It hasn't changed my mind. It's not going to make me a big Def Leppard fan. Didn't make me go, oh, I really can't wait to do another track by track in the future of a different album. I'm like, all right, we'll get to a different Def Leppard album when we get to it, kind of thing.
There's plenty of albums.
Yeah, because the thing, there's nothing. It's done nothing for me overall beyond going, yeah, it's fine. It's fine. I remember a couple of the tracks on it aside now because of this, and that's about the best I've got. Yeah. Top three then.
No surprise that Billy's Got a Gun.
Yeah.
He's on my list. Die Hard, The Hunter, and Rock of Ages.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Okay. Well, we match up with Billy's Got a Gun, and I did Photograph and Stage Fright, the two that came quite early on that kind of had that kind of peppiness for me. But yeah, I mean, I could have swap that Stage Fright for Die Hard Hunter. Maybe not Rock of Ages, though, because I found out a bit cookie cutter. But there you go.
I like cookies, though.
Yeah, true. Def Leppard's Pyromania. You got any thoughts? Let us know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching. You can check us out on gbhbell.com, as well as on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Tumblr. Go to Patreon to help us out over there. That's patreon.com/gbhbl, as well as Big Cartel, where you can find some of our merchandise. We have a podcast running on SoundCloud and Apple Podcasts. And of course, if you like this video, do us a favour, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow. Games, horror and heavy metal. What else is life for?